Welcome to a new part of the ISM Statistics 1 exercise set, this time with an exercise on classified data. Let's take a closer look at the exercise. Data on monthly income before taxes has been collected and summarized in the following table. Add relative and cumulated relative frequencies to the table, calculate the median income, and calculate the average income. Let's work our way through those three tasks. Let's start with filling out the frequency table. So we have the absolute frequencies. So in addition to the absolute frequencies, we can calculate their sums, so the overall number of observations. And then we only add two additional columns, and in the columns we'll add the relative frequencies and the relative accumulated frequencies. Now that we have the overall amount of observation, the 170, we can easily calculate the relative frequencies by just dividing the absolute frequencies with the overall frequencies with the overall observation. So we go for the first one, it's 15 divided by 170, giving us 0.0882. Then 45 by 170, giving us 0.2647, then 78 by 170, giving us 0.4588, and finally 32 by 170, giving us 0.1882. If we were to sum up all of those relative frequencies, we will again get 1. Why 1? Well, this is 100%. So this is all there is. This is one way to check whether you've worked your way correctly through this second column in the table. We will see something similar in the next column as well. Next column is on relative accumulated frequencies. Here we always consider the frequency, the relative accumulated frequency of the class before the current class, and to this add the relative frequency of the current class. So what we're basically doing in the first one, well, we do not have any previous class, so we start with 0 plus the relative frequency of the current class, which is 0.0882, giving us the first value. Then to the 0.0882, we add the relative frequency of the second class. So we add the 0.2647, giving us an amount of 0.3529. And to this, we add the next relative frequency of 0.4588, giving us for the third class a relative accumulated frequency of 0.8117. To the 8117, we add the last relative frequency for the last class, and we get 1. This is, as I said, the second possibility to check whether you did everything right up to this point, because here in the end it always needs to be 1. So in the end, if you did the second column correctly, in the third column the end result, the last relative accumulated frequency, also always needs to be 1. Might be that with the relative frequency, the sum of the relative frequencies, or the last relative accumulated frequency, one might get a value like 1.0001 or 0.999999. This is due to rounding errors. But in the end, if you were to work correctly, it always should be 1. This in mind, we can then also ready carry on with part B. In part B, we keep the frequency table we just constructed, and we carry on with the median. The formula for the median looks as follows. So what we need for calculating the median is first off the median class. How do we find the median class? Well, the median class is the class where the relative accumulated frequency first becomes larger than 0.5. If we take a look at our table, we see here, this is the first time that the relative accumulated frequency becomes larger than 0.5. So here, this class from 1200 to 2500, that's our medium class. So what do the different parts of the formula mean? The ui minus 1, that's the lower bound of the median class. So here it's the 1200. Then we have plus 0.5 minus ci minus 1. That's the relative cumulated frequency of the class before the median class. So here it's the relative cumulated frequency of 0.3529. And this is divided by the relative frequency ri, the relative frequency of the median class, which here is 0.4588. And finally, we only have to multiply this with ui minus ui minus 1, which is just upper bound of the median class minus lower bound, so more or less width of the median class. So if we insert all those values, we get the following result. And we can input this into our calculator or any other way and get a final result for the median as 1616.8047. This then concludes the second part of this exercise, second of the three parts. And we can turn to the final part, calculating the mean. With the mean, we need two parts, as we can see from this formula. We need the relative frequencies, ri, and we need the averages of all the classes, that's the mi. How do we get the class averages? For this, we just add up lower and upper bound and divide this by 2. So if we consider the first class, here we have 0 and 800. The value just in the middle of this class is 400. And well, you get 400 by adding up 0 and 800, dividing the resulting 800 by 2. Same applies for the second class. Here we could add 800 to 1200, getting 2000, divided by 2 gives us 1000. And well, 1000 is the value exactly in the middle. So we do this for all four classes and always multiply the class averages with the relative frequencies and add all of this up, giving us the following result. Then we just input this into a calculator to get the final result of 1854.51. And thus, we concluded also the third part of this exercise. I hoped all of you enjoyed listening to this exercise and learned something from it. So until next time, see you and goodbye.